Hey, what's up? It's Václav here. This video is about security. One of the questions you've been asking me a lot. What if your neighbor attacks you? How do you secure your home assistant? And I thought, rather than answering those questions, I'm gonna make a video about it because I think it's an interesting topic. And this is gonna be my take on security, because I think there is no universal answer about security. I think security is always about finding the balance between usability, ease of use, and safety. I think there'll be a difference in securing bank and garden shed, right? Depending on what you're risking, I think the security should be relevant for that. So this is one of the things you have to think about, how much you're risking and how secure you would like to make that. And I'm gonna get back to it at the end of this video as well, because this is influencing some of the decisions I'm making as well. Then there is two other principles. One is I like to always have multiple lines of defense. So if one of the security measures is breached, to have something else that could stop the intruder. I think it's coming from the Netherlands, where they have those dams, they have experience with flooding, and they have learned quite painfully that if one of the dams collapses, they would like to have a secondary one to minimize the impact of such a disaster. So this is one of the things relevant for security as well. The final principle is, in security, the most important thing is the weakest link. There's no point securing everything very much and then leaving the door open. There's no point having the latest security system in your house if you leave the front door open, right? So this is one of the things you have to think about as well. I always try to address the weakest link, because this is going to have the biggest impact for the security. Then let's talk about different types of risk or security. One of them is risk of remote attack. Someone is trying to attack you or access your home automation from the internet. Because the second type is going to be local attack. So let's talk about the remote one, because for that doesn't really matter where the intruder is. Doesn't matter if he is 500 meters away from your house, or it might be in other continent. And for those types of attack, typically you might have attack to the home assistant itself. So they might like to find some vulnerabilities, open ports, try to attack the appliance itself. Or more typically, they could go through stealing your identity, stealing your account. So how do we protect against that? There's quite a few defense mechanisms included already in Home Assistant that you can turn on. One of them is you can set up maximum number of login attempts. So what Home Assistant is going to do is, if someone is trying to do brute force attack, trying different passwords, dictionary attack to your account, it will automatically, after 5 attempts from the same location, it will ban this IP address and lock it. So this IP address will be blocked and won't be able to try it anymore. So this is one of the defense mechanisms. The other one is multi-factor authentication. This is one of the features that is available in Home Assistant, and I have that set up on all of my accounts. Again, those two principles are playing here, right? The weakest link, there's no point having only one account secure if you want to have it. Let's make sure we have all accounts secured. And the other principle is, this is the secondary line of defense. If they get to your password somehow, then you have the secondary factor. The way multi-factor authentication is, it combines two factors, something you know, so this is your password, and something you have, so this would be the device, like your mobile phone, to which generates code every 30 seconds. So if someone gets your password, it will ask him for the code, which only you have. So again, this is increasing the security on that. Now, how do we prevent someone stealing your password? Obviously, using encrypted connection, so use SSL, use certificates, do not use unencrypted connection because someone could be listening to your traffic, maybe on the public Wi-Fi, and read your unencrypted password. So don't do that. Use encrypted connection. Speaking about public Wi-Fis, avoid them. Don't use unknown Wi-Fis. There's a Wi-Fi that sounds cool, you know, sounds obvious. You are at the airport, and there is a Wi-Fi that looks like it belongs to the airport. Make sure it's the official one, that someone is not creating an access point and playing man in the middle. And if you are using public Wi-Fis, I highly recommend to use some VPNs. So all the traffic through this Wi-Fi is going to be encrypted. So again, I'm layering those security layers one on top of the other. And finally, about passwords, don't store your passwords in your config files. Use the secrets. So in case somewhere you share your config files or someone gets to your config files, make sure those config files do not contain passwords so people can't read them. So this is about attacking the account, getting your user access. The other part would be if someone is trying to find a way to your Home Assistant. And for that, I'm personally using the Nabucasa, which is allowing remote access in a secure way through a proxy. So I don't have to leave a port open on my home network. So this is again one of the ways how you can avoid or close the door for possible attacker. And also for the devices that communicate with the Home Assistant, if every and each of those devices is going to communicate to the internet, you would have to secure each of those devices. And for that, I think limiting the number of holes in your network, making sure that all of those devices only communicate locally to Home Assistant within your network, and then you only can secure the Home Assistant instance. So for that reason, I try to avoid cloud devices, and if those devices try to communicate with the cloud, if possible, I try to filter them on the firewall so all the traffic remains local on my network and I'm only securing Home Assistant, which works to a point. Obviously, if you use some of the personal assistants, which I'm not going to name in case one of them is listening in your room, they need to be able to communicate to those devices as well. So again, here you need to make a decision, security versus usability. So I think this is about the remote attack. Let's talk about the local attack. If someone is going to get access locally to your house, here, make sure your Wi-Fi is secured. Personally, I have two Wi-Fis. One is which I'm giving to my guests. If someone comes to visit me, that I have a password which is easy, which I give to my guests. They have easy access to the internet, but they do not have access to the local network. And then I have a Wi-Fi, private Wi-Fi that we use, and we don't share the password. There is more difficult password there to use. You could also have a third Wi-Fi. I thought about it, to have a Wi-Fi for the IoT devices, but then I decided not to do that for the reasons, again, usability. Make it easy to communicate with your phone and those personal assistant devices, multimedia, and so on. And finally, about local attack, I think it's good to do some monitoring. You know, have your eyes open if there is something suspicious going on. If you see some devices on your network or things stop working, you see some alerts, make sure you can check out what's going on and you don't ignore those signs that someone might be attacking your network. So this is about local attack, secure network. Do not expose your devices. Don't make stupid, unsecure Wi-Fi. And the other thing is you might use some secure protocols because some of the devices, they use Wi-Fi to communicate, but you can also use Zigbee or Z-Wave to communicate internally. And I think these are essentially more secure because it's more difficult to communicate with them because they don't use standard Wi-Fi. Which brings me to the last topic, and this is about the risk management, you know, the balance between safety and usability. You have to always think what happens if, despite all of those security measures you have done, what happens if someone breaches the security of your home automation. One of the decisions I have made is I didn't do any automations that would breach the perimeter of the house, that would make it possible for someone to turn off the security system or to open the door or open the garage door. Those devices exist and they are easy, available.
Hey, open the front door, please.
All right, opening front door.
I decided I'm not gonna do that, which is going to then make it easier for me to make the system a little bit more accessible and easier to use, because all I'm risking is someone might turn on or turn off my lights. Okay, that's cool, but I'm not risking that someone is going to open the door and steal things from my house. So this is one of the things. The other thing is, obviously, what if the home automation breaks? What if people don't steal things, but they just break things? And for that, I think it's good to do backups. Make sure you test those backups to make sure that you can recover. And finally, I think I always think about the scenario, if there is no home assistant, and it's easy to test, you just turn it off. And you see how your house is working without Wi-Fi or without Home Assistant. Make sure that you can still, you know, do things, that you're not gonna die in the house if the home automation is going to be turned off. You know, this is one of the things I've been thinking about. I have those covers outside the windows, and they automatically shut down the covers based on the position of the sun. When I go out there to the garden, I always, you know, either turn it off or I'm taking my phone so I can open them in case they close whilst I'm outside in the balcony. So this is one of the things that you have to think about. All right, so this was my take on security. Let me know in the comments what you think. I'm not expert on security, but I do work in IT, so I do have some experience. But maybe some of you are security experts and you might have some suggestions how to improve security in general of the home automations. Okay, that was it, and see you in a bit. Bye.